Seem to confirm this is not a paid service. I'm not doing it for any money. I just want, I have seen your post. I'm just interested what kind of skill set do you have, and trying to create a mock interview for you. And I will update this in my online channel so that if you are good enough, then you will get the opportunities. Is everything fine for you?
Yes, sir. It's okay.
Fine. Thank you so much. So I have shared my screen. I'm having your resume on my desktop. Can you see it?
Yes, sir, I'm fine.
Okay, Rana, it will be better if you can speak a bit louder. Keep the microphone near.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, I think I can hear you. Fine. So Rana, I know that you are a fresher.
Yes.
So please give me a small brief about yourself.
Yeah, myself Rana Pratap Reddy. I completed my BTech in Sanskriti School of Engineering, Puttaparthi, 2019 in mechanical stream. And coming to my family background, we are 4 members in our family. My father, mother, and I have one elder sister. I published one journal of 6-stroke engine.
Rana, one important thing, when an interviewer is asking about yourself, try to concentrate more on what is your education, and if you are currently working, then give me your working profile, or if you are not working, say me about your projects. See, family details can be put at the last.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. Please go ahead.
Can I start?
No need to start, just continue from your college.
Yeah, I completed my BTech in Sanskriti School of Engineering, Puttaparthi, 2019 in mechanical stream, and I published one journal on 6-stroke engine in IJSR. Okay. And I completed my advanced certification in UiPath, December 2019. Mm-hmm. And my hobbies are reading books and photography.
Okay, so when you're saying your hobbies, so you also need to see what is the job profile you are applying for. See, you are applying for some UiPath profile or some UiPath interviews. If it is possible, say something that is related to the job profile. That will help you.
Okay.
Now, when I've seen your post, I came to know that you have experience in UiPath. Am I correct or not?
No, sir. I'm not. I'm fresher. I don't have any experience.
So then why are you checking or why are you applying for UiPath or why are you applying for RPA interviews?
Sir, actually, I learned this course, my relative suggested me after completion of my BTech. I thought it's RPA having good future, yeah, but everyone is asking experience 1 year or 1.5 year. But
okay.
That's a difficulty here.
See Rana, there is something that I need to confirm with respect to your profile. See, you came from a mechanical background, and what kind of knowledge do you have in computer science, or what kind of knowledge do you have with respect to any programming language?
No, I don't have any programming language. Actually, I started learning Python recently.
Okay.
And this RPA, UiPath, I learned previously.
Okay, so have you completed any certification with RPA UiPath?
Yeah, in UiPath I completed my certification. Advanced.
What is the certification?
Advanced certification, advanced.
So you have completed advanced developer certification in UiPath?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so can you explain me about state machine and anything about RE framework? Since you have already completed advanced certification, you should be able to answer.
Yeah, RE framework, it's a design structure one. It's like state machine design. It's having start function, and it's having start, after that init, get transaction, process, and the end process. This is the RE framework structure. In that init transaction, we read the data from config files and other data from browser or anything. In get transaction, if it's the data is read successfully, then it will go to transaction state. In the transaction state, that data from config file or any we scrapped or any other data from browsers or anything, in the transaction data, it will read total data. It will take the total data, and it will process. It will, if it's validated, then it will send to process. In that process, we are keeping main workflow. Suppose we are checking in one browser, something data we are cross checking. In that data, in get transaction data, we'll check in that process. In that process thing, if the data is validated, then it will go to end process. If any error means, it will go again transaction state or end state. It will show error. We have to rectify those things.
Instead, okay. So far, so good. So, can you explain me what is a transaction item?
In the transaction item, we collect all the data from config files or any. Suppose I told previously about data scrap from. We stored in Excel files in that init transaction. That data will be readed in this transaction file, in this transaction data. It will read all, it will collect all the data from init state and it will send that data to process. In that init transaction, we that data we can transfer to it will collect some data from orchestrator queues and all.
Okay.
Then so, the data.
But you didn't answer my question. What is transaction item and what is the default type of transaction item in RE framework?
Transaction item default transaction.
Yes.
So transaction item is for collecting total data from some other files like Excel files and all.
No, that's not correct. Okay, can you say me about transaction data? It's okay. So what is the difference between flowchart and a state machine?
The state machine, it's divided into parts, means small parts. In the state machine, it's having start, after that state, and end state. In that state, middle of that, we can use how many we want. If we are having very big, we are designing one big process, in that we have to split that into state, and we can do that. It will be easier for doing that process and all. In that state machine, in flowchart we can do any big kind of process also, and it's having, we can connect nodes from one, it's also having same thing, we can connect nodes from one process to another process in flowchart also.
Okay, see, you're not specific to the answer, you're giving a general answer which sometimes will not give a proper impression while you're giving an interview. Okay, so be specific while you're saying about flowchart. Maybe a flowchart can be a pictorial representation or a easiest way where we can represent the flow of the process. While in state machine, there are states, and in that states we will have transactions, and in the transactions we can mention what are the, we can give some validations in the transactions to map it to a respective state. Okay. And have you worked on any project so far?
No, sir, I didn't work, but I practice. Generally, I practice some. In online, I checked and I practice something. I don't have any practical things on that.
Okay. Have you tried any? Why didn't you go into a mechanical stream job, and why did you come into computer science?
Actually, firstly, I joined in mechanical job.
Okay.
As a calibration engineer, few months I worked, and I didn't satisfy with that salary. And after that, mechanical department, some jobs are less at the time, because last year mechanical jobs are very less, and it's became too down. Lot of jobs are fired, lot of people are fired. That's why I came to this computer science.
Okay, so what is your interest in working with UiPath? Like, when I give you a use case, let's say that there is a data scraping activity that should be done on some website, and you need to write it into an Excel.
Yeah.
So what are the steps that you will follow?
Sequence, open browser, and data scraping.
Okay.
And we take one Excel application scope. In that, we create one path like our Excel file, or we can select from device Excel sheets also.
Okay.
In that we that after scrapping the data is stored in data table, we take that data table into the write range. We use write range and we keep that data table. After that, it will write the data into Excel file.
So what if the data is unstructured? How can you extract the data from unstructured? So what is the difference between structured data and unstructured data?
Structured data means it's in table type. It's having name, first name, last name. It will be in structure shape. We can scrap directly whole table in one data table. In unstructured, it's not in, if it's first name in left side means second, last name in right side, that type unstructured data.
Not completely correct. Okay, what if there is no table? Let's say that there are some list items. Can we extract the data? So what kind of data is it? Is it structured data or unstructured data when we have list items?
If it's list, means it's structured data, sir. We can scrap that in data.
So what, how can we scrap? See, one thing is we cannot scrap directly using click activity, and we cannot extract the complete table. So what are the other options do we have?
You are asking about in data scraping only?
Yeah, you can say.
Yeah, we select in, it's having some headings or any, we select two same things in that. It's, suppose it's having in list also, it's having first name, second name, last name.
Okay.
In that we select first name, then it will ask select some more, I mean structured one. In that we select second name or last name, then it will ask the, we have to scrap the total table or not.
Okay.
If we say, then it will scrap the total data in that page.
Mm-hmm.
If it's having any multiple pages also, it will ask if is there any multiple pages, then we can select that one in next, means it will scrap total things on that.
Can you please share me your certification, UiPath Advanced Developer Certification?
Mail or
person? You can share your screen.
Yeah.
And while you're doing that, let's see something important. One thing I would like to say, your resume is not having important points. You have said you have RPA in UiPath experience, but you did not mention anything that what you have done in with respect to UiPath. Maybe you can skip some projects and say that this is what I have done in that project. See, when we say project, it need not be only in particular organization. Even something that you have done on your own, which shows your ability or your skill set to perform some solution or to perform some job and to get the things done, can also be placed in your resume. Okay. So first thing, please update your resume. Update your resume in such a way that you have some projects in your resume, and if possible, keep a GitHub repo where you post all your codes online. Make sure they are commented well, so that if someone checks your code, they can understand it. Okay.
And actually, I didn't did any projects or not real time. I practiced some things which I took some browser or anything. I practiced some basic.
See projects. That, Rana, that should be enough for a entry level candidate. Okay. We are not asking you to come up with a complex project and do. What I am exactly doing is, if I see your resume, I need to see what are the things that I have already done, or what are the things that you have already done, and if you can show it to or not. Okay, fine. Please share your screen and show me your UiPath certification.
I'm not able to share, sir. Your screen is.
Okay, send me your attachment over a mail.
Okay, I will share it now. Can I share in LinkedIn?
Yeah, go ahead.
It's done, sir.
Okay. Okay, we have your advanced RPA developer advanced certification. So can you say me about the use cases that you have done in the advanced certification? Like what are the use cases and how did you solve them? And what are the issues you found while creating this, while getting this certification?
They gave me one scenario called in Acme test. They asked me to scrap data from that vendor, from some vendor application. In that only I scrapped the data and I saved in one Excel file. After that I have to check that vendor ID, the data is correct or not. In that what I did is, firstly I log in, I create one XAML file for logging into that Acme one, into that browser. After that I created another XAML file for scrapping the data. After logging into that Acme browser, I selected vendor option. In that they gave me some list of data in that application. I scrapped total data and I saved in one Excel file. After that I have to check that data into, again in that vendor ID, I have to place that vendor ID into that browser and I have to cross check the data is present or not. For that, firstly, for logging and all, I XAML file, I kept in that init transaction. After in config file, I kept one URL, this Acme login URL, and I connected this Acme URL into in that. I connected that argument into init transaction. After that, I use means. That data which I saved in Excel file, I have to enter that in vendor tax ID and I have to check the data is present or not. For that I use, in that process I created this one. In that I took one Excel scope. In that I took one read range. For that I took one for each row. Then
It's fine. Take chill and answer. And why didn't you develop this in RE framework?
Yes, sir. I did it in RE framework only.
Then where for each is used?
For looping one by one.
Mm-hmm.
If it's having 50 data, we have to loop one by one, right? That's why I use for each.
Okay. Why didn't you use a select query for that or filter data table?
Sir, we are not filtering that data. Actually, they are having data in the browser only. Again, they are having that same application. I have to check this vendor ID into that. I have to check if that data is present or not.
Okay.
And if we want to scrap that data also means, we can scrap, and if we use this one append range means it will scrap the total data one by one, whichever we entered.
Okay. So did you use orchestrator in this?
Yes, sir. For queuing, I use for queue.
So what is a queue and how it is useful?
Queue is used for this one. It will loop one by one, sir. It will save that data in orchestrator and it will do without any, I mean, if Excel file is corrupted or anything means it will give proper data.
Okay.
Once we added into queue means it will give one by one to that process without getting any, it will reduce the error.
So what is the activity that you used to get the transactions from the queue? What is the activity?
No, sir. Actually, I didn't took that from queues.
Now, if you want to take values from queues, which activity do you need to use?
We have to give that path of queue into the in RE framework. We have that option. We can give that queue name. By that, we can take that data from queues only. If we place that queue name in this RE framework, it will fetch the data from our queue RHS data queues.
So what difference do we have, or can we use this RE framework other than queues?
Sorry?
Without using queues from orchestrator, can we use the RE framework?
Yes, we can use.
What is the difference, or what kind of changes do we need to make?
In queue, in transaction data, it's having that queue option. We have to change that one first. The transaction data, in those things we have to change.
So what will you change, transaction data or transaction item?
Transaction item.
Okay. So let's say an example that we are using a data table as the input. Now what can be a transaction item?
This data which is present in the Excel sheet.
So what is the transaction item?
Transaction item, that data only.
Okay, you're saying the transaction data is the data table. What is the transaction item? So when you have a list of files, let's say that we need to process a list of files in a folder. Okay, now what is the transaction item and what is transaction data?
Transaction item, which is the total file, is transaction item, and the transaction data, which is present in that file.
Mm-hmm. No, actually you're saying in the opposite. Transaction data will be the complete data. Transaction item will be only one file. Okay. Okay. Fine, Rana. Let's stop this interview for now. What I completely understood from the interview is, see, you have a bit of coding knowledge and you are able to complete the certification. What exactly you need to do right away is to update your resume as soon as possible and to make sure that whatever, like, given the certification code that you have written is something kind of a project, you need to update that this is what I have done and these are the issues that I have faced and how are you able to solve it. Okay, once you update the resume, you send it back to me. I will review it. Maybe we will not have a call again like this, but I will give you a reply over an email.
Can I add my project, sir, which I did? I will show you a few.
Sure.
I don't know.
But you are not able to share your screen.
Yes, sir. I can say which I did. Actually, I did one live NSC data. Actually, NSC data, it will update daily, right? What are the stock market and all? I did that one. And I developed one thing. It will scrap all data company wise and it will store which is a leading one and which got losses. And another one is which is called Parcel Monkey website.
Mm-hmm.
In that it will check the parcels and what is the cost of that parcel sending from one place to another place. Those kind of things I did.
Excellent. Those are good projects for a beginner. So just what you need to do is you just need to update the same in your resume. Okay. So the next time you do a post in LinkedIn, what you do is post what are the things that you have done as well.
Okay.
Because when people are seeing your post or when people are seeing your profile, what they are really interested is what you have exactly done and how the work that you have done can help others or their organization while to get an interview.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Rana. It's nice talking to you. I'll completely update this particular interview on LinkedIn and as well as in my YouTube channel so that I can share it with my contacts as well as you can also share the same video within your organization, or if you're not working, within your friends, so that they will get to know what exactly you are capable of. Because the problem that most of us are having right now is people are not even getting the interviews at this point of time. If you can share this video, maybe they can just check the video and come back to you asking for some more details.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Rana. Thank Have you. Fun. Bye. And keep learning. Bye.